Walks up to Steve Jobs and goes, "Hey, look at this. What do you think?" Steve goes, "I put a bigger pill in it, baby. You know it. It's a $20 charge right there." All right, so we're going to TRZ Motorsports X275 and a man in the water box right now. Jeff Kyle out of Wake Forest, North Carolina. Carrot Top putting him in the beams. Getting him lined up. The 2000 Mustang sitting number three with a 483. The Chevrolet in the left lane. You see it all happening right there. Right lane's going to be the Ford Mustang of Kyle. Look at him clearing out that big beast, man. 434 small block, three stages. What category? X275. I think he went and bought a tech car because he wants to run Outlaw 275 too. This is his first hit.
That has got to be right up there in the top five. We'll see as the computer comes down seven. Gets the number seven spot right there with that run of 92.6. But look at Kyle. Number one qualifier running the door doors off it and put Neil down. You know, it's gotta be pumped. And we talked about Terry moving back up, now Jeff Powell gets the top spot.
What in the world are he doing?
Break his neck.
Hey, he rolling for that 474.
Yeah, he got his arm up, yo. He all right.
Danny Griffiths in the Mustang left lane. Corey Berry, tower side.
X275. He broke his axles. He lost his studs. He broke some studs.
Drivers in lane four, suit up. Drivers in lane four, suit up. Little burn down on the starting line. We've been waiting about 15 minutes for these cars to get in. There we go.
No, it ain't too. Look like him though.
You see that big black guy? You know, that guy ain't with it.
Mike.
Look at that. Someone's got some head products on their car. Rick's walking up there, XL Turbo. Here's Corey Berry. No, Corey Wendt, I apologize. This is Holly Berry.
Dave Hill in the TRZ Motorsports Mustang out there in the left lane. Steve Whitaby in the Mustang tower side. Number 9 qualifier with a 5.03.
Hesitation,
right in. So right now they're running 5.54. They went even quicker. Where's it going to get them? We're going to find out here in a second as soon as they cross the line. 54 gets them to number 36. Not enough to get in that field, man. Aaron Stapleton at number 16. Go down, hit the buttons. Let's see who's at 32. Who's on the bump right now? Daniel Large is on the bump at 5.39.2. That's what you need to go quick to get in the game.
Daniel Large, he earned the right to get number one qualifier first round.
There you go. That's what it's about. Here comes the Sarge himself coming up here. Jason Lee, 86 Mustang, 365 cubic inches. Strange engineering all over that thing this year. And the right side, you got Cordell coming up. Right there in that little red car. 99 with an 8, 99 flat, 97. Lee stays number 3 in qualifying with that shot at a buck 42. Now you got Small, who's in the front of the pack, living up to his name, 488.9. Believe me, there's no Napoleon complex there, baby. That guy's ready to hit him hard.
There you go, Enrique Rodriguez out there in the left lane. Sits number 24 in the field. He's got the Chevy Power under the hood of the Ford Mustang tower side. Rich Bruder, the Pro Charge machine, Mustang Mike standing right behind him, checking it out. Little small block F1R. Rich had that thing, stood it up on the bumper, banged the bottom earlier yesterday. They worked on it through the night. Let's see if they got it figured out. Trying to get it back into the fours. He's done it before.
Thank you.
turbocharged machine climbing the ladder, baby.
You're not kidding. Number seven qualifier, Rich, going down there. Rudder right there. He'll find himself qualified, and we'll have to wait till they get that thing across the eighth mile times in the left lane. That wheel stand really did some damage there for Eugene Rodriguez over there, number 24 qualifier.
That's a beautiful color blue.
You're not kidding. Battle of the sleepers right here. No wins implied, but here is Reagan. Rutland, Indiana, 93 Mustang. Look at that thing. Dang, is that a cool looking car. Big power on board. Sherry said, I've had enough. She's going to go down and get a lemonade as they turn on the nitrous oxide and Hans machine. And yeah. At least that thing's not walking like it's been all beat up or flat tired.
Dennis Smith, we need racer Dennis Smith to the head of staging lanes. Dennis Smith, come to the head of the staging. So there you go, Rich Reagan in the Mustang in the left lane, the baby blue, spurging the nitrous. Steve Hahn in the Mustang tower side, the silver Mustang. You see his wife down there videotaping, Shannon from Davis Traction Control Technologies down there. John Sears watching.
Look at the difference, and we're not trying to cut anyone out of the program, but one car not spinning, the other car just hooking up and putting it down there and qualifying.
So there you go. They got it great on one kit. They'll turn on the second and third kit, and then it'll get better. That 1969 Chevelle 565 big block with a whole lot of nitrous under the hood. Bubba Harris, here it is. He can't have a race in Georgia without Bubba. Somebody go get Bubba. Tell him there's a dragon race. I'm bringing out the Mustang.
Bubba, me by my lemon shrimp.
Bubba was my best good friend.
Here is Bubba now trying to do it as he gets ready the 93 Mustang. Clickety clack, man. You know what's funny is that we all ran that old Chevy truck.
Mustang in the right lane spins a tire. Chevelle in the left lane. Shannon from Davis Traction Control down there videotaping. Doesn't spin the tires, runs a number. How about that? I tell
you. There you go. Someone may want to go get hooked up with some of that traction control here this weekend. And you got another shot of qualifying. Have them hook it up and see what it does. Right now, the Fairmont's coming up. It's Jimmy Plimpton out of Frankville, Wisconsin. 79 Fairmont, 582 cubic inches. A big body Ford down there. Plimpton ready to hang them high. Keep your eye on that car.
All right, we need the kids that are rolling down the hill over there on the spectator side. You guys, your parents, you got to stop them from rolling down the hill before one of them gets hurt. So the little kids down there rolling down the hill, we can't have that over there, please. Dustin Mewborn in the Mustang, the Mo Money Machine. They down there partying like hell in the pits last night, and they're out here racing hard today.
Let's watch the reaction time and see if that old juice paid off. Newborn will be there in the left lane. Watch the kid who usually cuts the tree down, Plimpton. Yeah, like you can't hear me. Johnson down there with the duck right now. Here's the pickup truck. Flames all over that thing. Clint Lonnan now out of the water box area. And I'll tell you what, Chris, he's got a good old burnout right there. He put some heat into the tire. Number six qualifier, 498 with a 7. 139, 522, 25th. And qualifying's the big pick-em-up truck.
So there you go, the fast forward race engine machine. If you check out the X275 license plate on the back, that is available down. There's a trailer. There's a trailer down there next to the whole shot wheels display. It's Stop down there and get you one of those X275 license plate, represent the class. Got the X'd out Skull 275. They're available for $20 here at the track.
Good run for the Mustang.
Tim Hendricks, tower side in the Firebird. Left lane, Andy Manson, the mod motor Vortec powered quarter max Mustang out there in the left lane. Number 8 with a 503. Tower side 506, good enough for 15th. See Brian Petrie out there. Brian, do you get a picture of that Mustang, the Mo Money, doing the big wheel stands? He said, hell yeah. So Bill Clary sitting 20th, left lane, Mike Freeman 17th, tower side. Put it under your chin and don't blow off. Chad Baker out there in the left lane. Al's favorite driver, tower side in the Chevy 2. Ziff Hudson. Side in the Mustang 565, the big block nitrous car. Left lane, little block. Dale Handy, Carrot Top helping him put him out there.
Look at the Straw Boss down there in the left lane, hanging out, trying to watch it. Handy, that is a cool little car. Matters loves them all. He's got the Ford on the bow tie action going this weekend, but he says, I'll take the blue oval. Which one? Who knows? Radial tires versus the world in 1 and 2. Radial tire versus the world to lanes 1 and 2. Radial tire versus the world to lanes 1 and 2.
Getting into it and just staying into it.
What's under the hood?
Well, I'll tell you, there it is. 380 cubic inches. It's a muscle with an F1R. That is a 3-time world champ last year, Chris Evans. Here's the funny thing. Eric McMillan, the car with all the controversy. The turbo, is it legal? Is it not legal? He's been running it all weekend. He's in the left lane. He's the number 5 qualifier with a 498. Tower side, it's Big Green, Chris Evans, and Matt Bertram. 500 with a 5, good enough for number 7. That car's been into the 493s here at this racetrack. Let's see if they can put it into the fours right here and take over number one. Battling for that spot, he'll stay number two in qualifying. Here's a Flying Hawaiian out of Georgia with an 86 Mustang of Bob Kurgan. Many times the legend in the sport. Need we say any more? This guy knows how to get the job done. Now he would also like to get in the 4 second range. 513, 7138. He's got the Schwartz to be with you here on the right side. Chevrolet 72 model Nova as Pacini hits the puddle getting ready.
Boy, I tell you, get the cameras ready in the left lane. Bob had that thing on the bumper three times in the same run last night.
Great driver, and I'm not trying to take nothing away, but he knows the minute that thing comes up, I'm not busting pieces and ripping cranks out of it, hitting the pavement. So Kurgan shuts it off. He'll let all the oil come back to where it belongs, and hopefully he'll get to fire her up and shut the nitrous, or not the nitrous, maybe.
Yeah, I hope he doesn't have nitrous.
He's got
Vortex.
One in his leg there. I'm sorry, Vortex.
All right, Bob, gonna get out, look under the car, make sure everything's okay. Kind of came down pretty good. He's looking. We'll see. Oh, the wonderful photographer there. Who got a good shot of Bob with the wheels up out there? There you go.
Last night.
Yeah, but the live feed's going to cut off at 1400 for them.
Oh, that's right. That's right. Get it while you can. It's coming up. Enzo, big burnout, man. He gets the hides of smoking right there. 88 Mustang putting out the hoofs. And in the right side, Drakeford. This is going to be a good run. Enzo's got something to prove. And that would be, if you look at the qualifying, how close these two are. They're right next to each other. Enzo right under at number 12. Drakeford, number 11, 05 to an 06. Pacini wants that 4 second range. Oh, these guys have been right at each other. And you know, if they keep it up, they're going to find each other going at it maybe in the middle of the field here at the first round.
You know, they want to meet in the finals. They'd love to do that.
What do you think of the Pacini going to 490? Got it in it?
You know, I think both these cars got enough under the hood to go 490s. It'd be great to see them dead even on a tree going to 490s.
Spots right there, and believe me, those guys are going to be battling all day. So good to see the little Mustangs running good as the Chevrolet of Cherry comes up. Cherry, Ryan the driver, number 36 in qualifying, not in the field of 32. Eric Kennard over here on the right side, who has not yet qualified for this event.
That's one of the other TRZ Motorsports Mustangs. Eric usually drives the big wagon. Patriot Performance on board with them.
Loses his. They got to glue those things in.
I need TRZ Motorsports, X275, that are back in the staging lanes for parents. Bobby! What it is, bro?
Yellow shirt.
You steering or is Justin? Who's steering? That's what I'm saying. Oh, yeah. Get it done. Take that money back up north, right?
What you say?
Thank you.
right down to the stripe at 535, 132 miles per hour. Right lane.
Boy, I tell you, he wasn't scared over there in that Chevelle. Right lane, 51 for Strickland.
Look at this wagon. Building components for your suspension on your hot rods, your street cars, whatever it be, from A-arms, all types of neat stuff to make them hook. TRC backing up now, and who's doing the driving of the TRC?
Hey, Aaron Kenworth, we got to send a big congratulations back home to Mrs. Kenworth.
Hey, for that epidural somehow, he's trying to win this class right here. On the wagon. They pulled all the juice out and didn't let it hit until about half track. That car's been 490s.
Wow, look, they're all talking about it too. Maybe you ought to put the big tune up in it. The track will hold it. Right now, the dart's coming up there. 68, what do we got? 70, maybe, right? Dodge dart? 69.
It's your favorite year.
Yeah, absolutely. As long as they got a roll barn, it's not going upside down. Yates over there and the guys down there.
Oh, this is the big flag on the roof. And the horn did it.
Anyway, down there to Miles Brower, another Mustang getting ready to rip up. This one goes out to all the guys down there in Kentucky. Saying Underground, what is it, Underground 52? Chris, what are those guys, that a group that hang together?
I wouldn't know.
No. No.
The internet, what's that? Getting down right now with Billet Atomizers Racing Injectors. If you got an EFI machine, you need some fuel injectors, they gotta be absolutely perfect. You can't have something spraying 60 pounds.
Local. 275, y'all. All he right, on the 275.
Racer that needs a near chance.
He on the 275.
Five stater.
Prefers see how she do.
So a near chance.
Orange man
four
racing.
Or five stater.
Hey, Logan's down there. Logan, did you get
should
that shot?
Should be good, y'all. We'll see.
No, but watch the Nats. So watch the Nats,
huh?
Logan.
Yeah, thanks, man. Appreciate
that. Is that a stereo, too?
Yeah, HD and everything.
That was expensive.
Well, it took me for it took me a whole show to make enough money to do it. I needed it, though. You know how it is. Yeah, you know how it is. Check this out. Just take this. And I got a couple of DVDs or something over there. Right over here in the corner. You can see. You can get one here. I'll let you play it.
Okay.
All right. I'll bring it back over here in a minute, all right?
Concrete bleachers, the grandstands right there with Jammer Racing Ministry. Go in and Mark Walton is
ready for right,
ceremony for you at 8:30 a.m. Thanks to DragStory.com.
All right, y'all. Here we go.
Okay, so
won't cut the cake. It'll just get you a hot dog and probably a good old soda pop at the concession stand at 123 miles per hour.
Spot, right?
Absolutely. That's some good stuff. I love this car. Getting ready as you hit the button. That is a grain barge getting ready to come out of the water over there. Look at the size of that Super Sport Chevrolet. Bar. I believe you say it like that. Tow bar? Hope he doesn't need one today.
This is Mini-Me on the window.
This Mini-Me over there. Back it up. Parachute is packed. That is a cool, cool car, man. Who do you have in the right side?
Running up, it's Johnny Kennedy. He says the BMF on the back window. So he just wants to be like old Keith Barry back there in the room machine, but we'll see what the little Mustang got. Still looking for six. So you got the big Super Sport taking on the little notchback Mustang.
Yeah, half the car in the right lane. Rolling up the Super Sport. Ever so gently looking at the top of the lights, the pre-staging area. Remember, the eighth of a mile as you're watching here this weekend. I'm sorry about that. Number 5 qualifier, 526, finds himself up there breathing pretty strong.
Justin Smith, they won't see you. I don't know, they called the way they hit it.
570. 1-2, 570 cars to 1-2. 570 cars to 1-2, 530 cars to 3-4.
You'll talk to them.
Yeah. All right, so check out the water box down here. The TRC machine is back. On the attack, man. They had some problems. They said, oh, they fixed it. They did what they had to do. Jason Smith in there. Kirk Hartley, excuse me. This is the new father here driving.
That's right, Eric Kenward.
Cars commute, wagons haul in this case. Got the new baby seat bolted into the back.
Tell you, if they tune ups in this thing, Al, it'll go up on a bumper and it'll stay here for about 450 feet.
A drag racer right there. Neil Hawkins had the number one spot at 22.6. Just got beat by 522 flat, 133. Unreal. Here's Lee Pennington. Calera, Alabama. Nice looking 69 Chevrolet Chevelle. This thing is gorgeous, man. Big body, small block under the hood, 420.
A good old run right there. He's down a bit on his pace.
The quickest of 25, and now he finds a 5:38. Ricky Pennington, number 5 in qualifying. Now we'll bring up our next competitor.
Here we go. Check out this beautiful Cobra Mustang on the starting line. Neil Hawkins. Now this guy was the number 1 qualifier. He went 22 with a 6 until the TRZ wagon just knocked him down 22 flat. Index to 1 and 2, 530 index to 3 and 4, 570 index to 1 and 2, 530 index to 3 and 4.
There he goes.
with an 8 at 136 miles per hour. Not enough to earn the number one spot, but man, enough to scare number one. The winner on this weekend. That car's run so consistent.
It's a bracket car.
It is just sick consistent on that machine.
You should run the 530 index class.
Here comes the next car to the starting line. Man, there's so many dartboards here this weekend. I think the Irish pub uptown lost theirs. Dart's coming up in the right side. It's going to be Aaron Yates out of Middleville, Georgia. 1969 Dodge Dart 422 under the hood. Last time this thing hit the tire, sounded like it was going to ring the bell at the state fair. Watch this. Number 14, he's in. Couple spots in up the 16th ladder. At a 130.
Meep, the Roadrunner about ready to make a hit.
There you go.
Oh, he's pulling off, yeah, he's pulling off.
So far, 159. Kyle pouring it out. He just found 6 miles, about 5.5 miles per hour out of that car. 478.2, your number one qualifier. Ilm and the guys sitting there at number two. Terry, gonna have to wonder about forgetting about mile per hour. It's about ET right now. Can he find some ET in that machine to find that number one spot?
Well, I'm thinking so. Then when we go to letters, it'd be A or Z. What would it be?
Will be Z. All right, I need TRZ Motorsports X275 to 5 and 6. TRZ Motorsports X275 to 5 and 6. There's a Mopar battle shaping up on the line for you, Al.
Yeah, look at that. It's a battle of the men who parked in the back of the McDonald's their whole life. Man, oh man, here they are in the right side. It's going to be that bad to the bone Indy cylinder head machine of Bill Mays. He's been around many, many years. Mays Foley stages, and he's not going to be complaining too much. David Braxton over there with a good juice. the good juice over there, and the good juice being the induction solution juice out of North Carolina, 71 Dodge Demon, number 16, the man on the bump, trying to buy some real estate.
All right, double bumped him. They're going to back him up. Oh, yeah, get up on the two-step. That'll look real funny.
Oh, man, I'm telling you what, you talk about putting heat in the converter.
They got to let him back up.
No double bub, no double bub.
There you go. He's just trying to, all he's doing is getting back into his mode. Once you're locked in, you're like an astronaut. You say, no, can I change my mind? Not make the field at 577, the Indy cylinder head, Indianapolis machine, not enough to get in at 123 miles per hour, but Braxton takes the pitchfork out, sticks it in the ham hock, finds another round.
Steve Johnson at
number
a
16. Ooh, he's sweating it now.
You're not kidding, man. You better have that stick of right guard on. Kyle over there running some strong numbers. We hit the buttons and find out. Dwayne Schultz coming up in the Pontiac out of Harlem, Georgia. Who do you have in the left lane there? Oh, for sale.
Tower side of Pontiac is for sale. Corey Jordan in the Mustang in the left lane. Number 11 with a 513. Tower side, a 490. Good enough for number 6.
Don't forget, Pontiaction all the way right here. Number 6 qualifier. Corey, on the other hand, the old Mustang, well, not too old, out of Tooney, Alabama, it's qualified number 11, 513, 147 miles per hour. Let's see what we got here. GM trying to make a battle out of this qualifying session. Number 11 qualifier just wants real estate, man. He wants to breathe. You go, girl. Don't quit running. Forrest Gump's granddaughter. Pete Rickerson coming up out of Grovetown, Georgia. The primered red machine. Well, it's primered black, a little bit of red on the car. Oh, man, not a great place to take a leak right there. I'm telling you, it did have a little bit of spillage right there. And that's a shame when you're sponsored by Depends. The left side, Ron Romanek, McDaniel, coming up in the left lane. Turbo Dan will sit his chance and watch and see if he can get that thing to hook up. But right now, McDaniel gets a shot at the track in the left side to try to get into this qualified field. He's out. Let's go, Jen. Not enough. 558 just makes him look better. You know what I mean? He stays still in the number 20 spot. Shows that he had a fast car. Next two to the line. Who do we got? It looks like Ferris's brother, right?
It's Turbo Dan. Justin Brixley, tower side. That big block, 568. Four stages in a beautiful Buick. Turbo Dan out there. He's got the big block.
Who are you picking? I know you're a GM guy, Bull. He's going to Buick.
Oh, yeah. We got to go with the bat in the bone there. Right lane.
The thing is, a billboard going down the eighth of a mile, those mile per hour, isn't it? It's like when you're a kid, you put your hand out the car window. Remember that? Young kid, hand out the window, and it ended up on the back windshield.
Had the little vent window, used to flip it open.
My dog used to do that.
Hang the tongue out, dry up the rain gutter.
He'd wash half the car.
Did Turbo Dan get enough to get in? 24 get him in the game? We gotta wait for Jen down there at the top. Jen on the block, let's see it. She goes to the qualifying list.
Well, we had to wait for the Buick to actually put a time in because he blew up and stopped at 200 feet. So Turbo Dan.
Hey, Ernest.
Well, these guys are really beating me up here. They just give me the microphone when they don't want to talk no more. Can you imagine that Big L not wanting to talk no more? Hey, we still like that Buick getting pushed back there. Just keep your hands off the paint. That's a nice looking paint job on there. We don't want your DNA on that paint, please.
Just lay across the hood.
It's nice. Now America's Most Wanted's going to be up here trying to find him. Thanks, Bull. We're going to push the Buick off. Yes, sir. You go, young lady. Thanks for your help pushing the car. Watch out, fans. Try to back up there a little bit.
How about my man with the camera helping push? He's ain't worried about taking pictures or helping guy get off the track.
Category of Outlaw 275 versus 28.105 BP race fuels. Bringing it to the house this weekend.
That's right. VP, they closed up for today, but they'll be back open tomorrow. Jason spending the rest of the afternoon on the star line. Chris Bunch in the Mustang in the left lane. Bobby Flippin. Bobby Flippin now. Justin Smith jumped out of seat. Bobby Flippin is in the wheelhouse on that Camaro with 4.88, 145 miles an hour. It's a nitrous small block 434 applied nitrous solutions technologies nitrous on board. If you know the name Bobby Flippin, you know the old farm truck, the little red S10 that he has known to drag the bumper up
1,000 feet. He knows how to get it done on the small tire on the least springs.
The car ran a silly number, and Justin said, hey, I want to win this thing. I need a guy that can cut down a tree. So there you go. Bobby Flippin jumps into the driver's seat. Watch that Camaro. He'll hack the tree and run a number right there.
Now, did you say small block Chevrolet going against a big block Ford over there?
It is. It is.
How about that? Lane. He's going to spin that thing probably 10,000 RPMs and get the job done. He's going to eat up that Mustang and spin him out at the other end.
We'll see. Bobby Flippin been known to do that a time or two in his truck, and he's done it last year. He drove the car down here. That was a good call switching drivers. Bobby 017 on the tree. That's his first hit off the trailer. He's been crewing for the whole weekend. That's not bad when you can get off of crewing and go 017 and just cut it down, baby.
That was an incredible driving job. Now, you talk about the chassis being unloaded. That thing was well unloaded. And that kid stayed with it. Came down, went up, came. No, not like that, but he just did this a few times. Sorry, Jen.
Easy. You're going to get Tim excited again.
Man, oh man, two Mustangs coming in. There's only one little corral. Can it hold them both? Number 19 in qualifying. Duramus over here out of Greenwood, Louisiana.
Slows down a couple, man, big time. Almost 3 at 5:21, 144. 5:43, that's the quickest run, and it looks like he still doesn't get in. Duramus.
Well, that'll bring up Joe Greathouse out of Oakland, Kentucky. Big shout out to the Underground 520 down there for Andy and the guys down in Kentucky. Hanging out, says thanks to TRZ. Big Bill Lutz is probably on his 18th elephant here this weekend. As they go into the right side, number three qualifier. Now you gotta remember, he was number one qualifier after first round. He lost it third round today. So he's sitting at number three. Hopefully he wants to get back up to number one.
He can do it too. Man, I've seen a lot happen on this hot track right here.
Pierre Burnley left lane, Joel Greathouse tower side. I tell you what, this is gonna be a door-to-door race right here. A couple cars going at it.
Well, 502, 530, the numbers over there for Burnley. Burnley over out of North Carolina, Greathouse out of Kentucky, the mom's the bluegrass state. Ever so gently, they're turning the onboard on. Greathouse will now get in. Johnny Casey, come on, man, get it on. Let's see this thing go to town.
Funny to see him in a crew shirt, isn't it?
There you go, Johnny K pumping the fist. There's a man that knows how to take number one off the board and give it to himself. Look at that. Puts Joel right on the pole, baby. Fourth round of qualifying, and he's standing alone at the top. Here's a guy you cannot count out, though. Coming up in the yellow machine in the left lane, Terry Ilm in the Cobra 410 cubic inch machine out of South Carolina. Irmo, South Carolina, not where Emo's from, but I'll tell you what, that number three qualified machine is going to be tough. After watching Great House, there's proof that that track's got it in the pudding right here. They can get these numbers to go. A 79 can turn in a low 70 right now, Chris.
Oh, I tell you what, he has been up to number one, and he got pushed back down to number three right there. Let's see if he can play leapfrog and jump back over and get back up to the number one spot. He's got to find about 0.05 of a second in the car. If he gets a 10th, he's in great shape. Let's see what we can see right here. He went 153 earlier today. Let's see what shakes out.
Guys, better pick up a couple logs next time.
This car, it's supposed to smoke.
Yeah, I'll tell them about you.
Small blocks limited to an M1R or an XI or a 2500 transmission, and they're limited to an 88mm turbo, and it's all done on a 275 drag rail. No slicks in this class unless you match the ass for you. So they're all way to the tire car.
Again, guy is amazing, man. Chevrolet truck backing up, ready to get it done right there. Flames on a side, and it will be Kenward Eric coming up out of Barrow Beach, Florida, home of the shark eating beaches.
Woo-hoo, Florida, yeah, you go tear them up, big dog. The brand new dad down there. Ooh, Barrow Beach, my favorite state, Florida. Yeah, where the sun shines.
There's the daddy, Eric Kenward, Patriot Performance, TRZ Motorsports, the Motorsports, the purple machine out there in the left lane. Eric trying to find a couple digits and move up the field. Let's see if he can get it done.
Hey, that's okay, a little S10 pick-em-up truck in the right lane driven by Brian Keith. He's like, no way is a Mustang going to beat me. He's, I'm going to put him under.
Right.
in the right lane that's had nothing but a share of fire out of the hood every day that he's run here. Now let's see if we can get the problem fixed, man. This thing gets out about 20 feet. Get your camera ready, Mark. You don't want to miss this one.
Which lane, man? Which lane?
Right lane.
Left lane.
It's not grass, yeah.
He broke!
We don't want no fires. He's got it under control. He's been charging on it all day. So Mike Freeman over in the left lane. Nobody swings. Traction control, big deal here. Scotty K, don't even start, man. Just get down under. Watch this thing in the right lane.
Oh, what do we got in the left lane there? We got another one of the Mustangs. 93 was here when they made that one. Heard by Bubba Harris. He's out of North Carolina with old Nash.
What did Matter say about all those guys? It's about the 500th guy this weekend you've heard in the stands called Bubba. Hey, you can't have a race in Georgia unless you bring a Bubba. Downside, Russell McMahon is literally 320 cubic inch. It's a little punch down 5 liter. Got that 88 millimeter equalizer on the front end of it, though. Makes a hell of a big difference, don't it, Al?
Oh, you are not kidding. Look at that. On the right lane, though, everybody is just hanging out. Patrick Barnhill hanging out over there. Hey, Luke's remembers Barnhill today. Those two used to really come and try to shake some heads up.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean, he's still turning my car on. Steve Hahn out there.
and the guys all hooked up is their traction advantage right here. So next year coming to the line, it will be Eugene Rodriguez out of Tampa, Florida. 1993 Mustang, number 27 in qualifying, will be on the right side. Mick Mellon, out of Axton, Virginia. Home of Lizzie Borden, number 2 in qualifying at 4.96 seconds, 134 miles per hour. Drivers in 5 and 6, load up. Drivers in 5 and 6, load up. So there you go, Eric McMillan, 88 on the front that caused all the controversy. Is it legal? Is it not legal? Well, my man's sitting number 2 in the field right now. I'll consider that legal. They ain't kicked him out of the track yet.
The record holder.
Check this thing out. Pounce the pavement in Milwaukee, Wisconsin daily. This young kid is Dr. Ford's son right here. Dr. Ford, the legend. Ford drag racing back in the Wisconsin area. Getting his kid to come to the line and his street driven to Fairmont. I know the car only being about 20 minutes from the local track up there. Jimmy Plimpton, Frankville, Wisconsin, 79 model. He's run 538 this year. He's got large over here in charge. Alfred Large is a wonderful crew chief vest, a rib earlier. She said, no thank you, it was awful kind. Thought Anthony would have just met or something.
How about the Fairmont? Started the weekend with a 5.9. He's got it down to a 5.30. Let's see if they find a little bit more.
To the starting line, we've got more competition and qualifying, excuse me. Here's Bill Clary on a black Shear Georgia 92 Mustang, 438 cubic inch power plant V8 number 23 qualifying in the left lane. Eric Lyles out of Columbia, South Carolina. So Cleary will be number 23 in Stater with a 17-135. 1969 big body Chevrolet Chevelle in the right lane. Yeah, you can see it. The shorts are moving. A D Fister up there. He says, yep, big bow ties, big blocks, and yep, grab your whatever. Here's the Mustang in the left lane, ready to rock and roll. And it looks like Joe Alvarez coming out of Liberty, North Carolina. Chris?
Oh, I tell you what, the classes are coming up, cracking open the NOS can up here in the tower. It's on. It is on. Let me tell you what, Joe Alvarez did not make a hit yet. Let's see if he can get into the field. Shannon pulling the big Chevelle sitting up there in 21st on the top half of the ladder. I am going to need 750 index to lane 3 and 4. 750 index to 3 and 4.
Some bow tie power, and I know I got the Ford guy shaking.
Man, he carried the front wheels 350 feet and just put them down and sliding around, and he never let off the gas and put up a number. How about the big steel body doing it?
You gotta love it, man. That is a grain barge right there when it comes to pulling down the old Mississippi. Ford Mustangs coming up a pair. Little hoof kicker, sour ball. Justin ready to go in the left lane out of Georgia. The Blakely, Georgia team, the 86 model Mustang, 347. Who do you got in the right lane?
I got Dave Griffiths. Chevelle, it's going to be on YouTube and it's going to be a hit. That's going to be one hell of a ride to watch.
1 million views in the next week watching that wheel stand. Man, was that cool. As they back up another one of those big old Chevys, SS Super Sport. Standing out there as Puddin runs down to get ready to make a hit maybe in this cool air that's coming in here.
Here's the big bad Monte Carlo in the left lane. Look at the red beadlocks on that thing. And the sad part is we had one bad to the bone Monte Carlo just disintegrate here. It's being Shane Stack last night. I wonder if they, did they load up, they get that thing out of here, or they get parts?
You know, I don't know, but there was a lot of stuff that came out the bottom. If they needed parts, they needed a whole lot of them. Hate to see it happen, but the good news is it went away and it stayed right in the middle of the groove. So Shane didn't have anything other than the explosion that went loose. The big land yacht here trying to get lined up. Open comp to 7 and 8. 750 index. 650 index. Open comp. 750 to 3 and 4. 650 to 5 and 6. Open comp to 7 and 8.
Go figure. Bull's standing there and Bull's got a buddy down there. You see how close things are? It's Bull and Shorts.
Yeah, right there on the starting line. Ed Schwartz out of Orlando, Florida. Came all the way up from Orlando, folks. He was at the Real No Bull Nationals Extreme last weekend. He's up here in Georgia wanting to take home some of that money. 70 cars. 5 TRZ Motorsports and Garrett Turbos. Well, I remember that from last week. That's right. This guy's got $750 more in his back pocket just to get up here. Oh yeah, that's a bat to the bone. That's another one of the moonshine drivers.
Boy, how about that? You get the little 275 car came down to your No Bull Racing, showed him what's up, didn't he?
I know, it's embarrassing. No big tire cars, just the little tire cars. No wheelie bars. We had cars with wheelie bars. We had cars with big tires, big motors. And this little car right here, small motor, small block, wins it. Dave Hill's a driver. This car is so fast, it's owned by another person. That's right. Josh, right there, just closed the passenger door, owns that car. He says, nope, it's too fast. I'm going to stick some young blood in there. Let him do the driving. David Hill out of Orlando, Florida, in the right lane.
So there you go, the Chevy versus the Mustang.